Another toll of the COVID-19 pandemic is the impact it's making on Hoosiers battling addiction. Limited access to treatment has led to a spike in the use of the overdose reversal drug naloxone.
So meanwhile, the state health department's resources, they're stretched thin in the fight against COVID-19. And so Amanda Sorrentino is holding the state accountable, ensuring that its announced program is accessible to anyone who needs it.
4,700. That is roughly how many Hoosiers have overdosed since the beginning of this year. And that's a 35% increase compared to this time last year. Now, that's why the state is putting forward $1 million to make sure thousands of doses of naloxone is available to any Hoosier family who is battling addiction to bring hope for successful recovery.
It's a fight that Dottie Grubb has been tirelessly fighting. Her 38-year-old son has suffered from addiction for the past 16 years. It's a lonely road, but Dottie has a tool to keep her son fighting another day.
I'm very thankful, and he's very thankful for naloxone, because it has saved his life several times. I've administered it several times.
Dottie is one of thousands of Hoosiers carrying naloxone in the case of an overdose.
Once the disease has hijacked the brain, it's no longer their choice, and we should do everything we can to save people, and especially when it is so easy as in using naloxone.
Douglas Hunsinger is the state's executive director of drug prevention, treatment, and enforcement. He says because of the pandemic and the lack of access to in-person treatment for addicts, it has been a brutal cycle for those facing addiction. With a $1 million state opioid response grant from the Health and Human Services Administration, the state partnered with the nonprofit Overdose Lifeline to fund 25,000 doses of naloxone all across the state.
This is the biggest thing that we can do right now while people are still a little disconnected, having to do things virtually and not being able to be in person. This is the one thing we can do that will ensure that we save as many lives as possible.
This is going to have a huge impact because it's 25,000 kits. Mm-hmm. We didn't have this much access. We didn't have this easy access. We didn't have this ability really 24/7 if required to get people the overdose reversal drug. So we're going to save lives.
This state-funded naloxone supply has been delivered to Justin Phillips, the executive director of Overdose Lifeline. And this cause is personal. Her son, Aaron, overdosed in 2013. She doesn't want any family to experience the same thing she did, and this is work she's already familiar with.
We know grassroots distribution is effective. We have the reputation in the communities. We have partners on the ground across the state that can help make this happen, and just grateful that we can really do some life-saving stuff in the middle of all this other difficult time in our country.
Dottie keeps her naloxone supply stocked through Overdose Lifeline and wants every person with an addicted loved one to do the same.
There's so many people that just don't understand the value of it and how important it is for everyone. Everyone should be carrying it.
The 25,000 doses of naloxone from the state is available to any family member, individual, or organization that distributes naloxone in the state of Indiana. Now, those requests have to be made through Overdose Lifeline, and they're working to get those processed between 1 and 2 days and shipped to your home. Working for you in Indianapolis, Amanda Sorrentino, WRTV.
Amanda, thank you. You can request the naloxone from the Overdose Lifeline's website, or you can email them at contact@overdoselifeline.org.